Wendy and Charlie, can I interrupt you for a minute?
Yes.
Long, long ago, Wendy,
yeah.
In 1974, you were in a stage play called Seven Keys to Doomsday.
Yeah.
And of course, Charlie reprised it
yeah.
with a finish.
Yeah.
Now, do you remember back in 1974 that you had an understudy who played the main Dalek but was your understudy, and she, I think, took the role on four occasions?
My agent rang me and said, how would you like to do Doctor Who on stage at the West End, the Adelphi Theatre? I said, oh, great, I'd love to. What will I be playing? So she said, oh, well, you'll be playing the Emperor Dalek in another part and understudying the girl assistant. I said, fabulous, smashing. So that's what happened. I don't know, I think I went to see the director and I got the role.
Right, her name is Jackie Dubin, and she's... As I open this door, Jackie will come through to join you.
Let's put it this way. All the guys who were playing Daleks, they were all very tall. And me, not being particularly tall, I couldn't sit down. So I had to push it along standing. And they had the luxury of sitting down and pushing it along.
Thank you.
Because you never know, when you're understudying, you never know whether you're actually going to go on or not. So you make sure you learn the lines just in case. We were supposed to be on for 6 weeks or more, but the IRA were bombing during that time, so they cut it short because people were scared to go into the West End. So unfortunately, we finished a couple of weeks earlier. I remember that the rest of the cast were very, very nice. Also, there was an incident actually when Wendy Pabra and I, for some reason, we both had to go inside the Dalek, and the girl assistant, the boy assistant, spun the Dalek round so fast that it tipped and we fell into the orchestra pit, which was really frightening, but it wasn't during the show, it was during one of the rehearsals. So that was quite scary actually. So Wendy was off and I was going, I knew I was going to be on for four performances. Well, I didn't know how long actually, because I didn't know how long I should be off for, but I knew I was on that night and afternoon. So in the morning, I had to rehearse with the cast and I had my own clothes on. I was wearing black flared trousers and I was rushing to the TARDIS and screaming. And at that moment, the producers walked in to the theatre to watch what I was doing, and my trousers split. They split from crotch to ankle, so they had to rush me off to Carnaby Street that morning to get some clothes for me to wear for the performance that afternoon and evening. I did a documentary for somebody who was at Croydon College of Art, and his project, he decided to do our show, which was Doctor Who and Seven Keys to Doomsday. So he interviewed me and I was in the documentary. And then Tony Jordan, the organiser of the Appreciation Society, had an idea of bringing me on as a surprise guest. And I hadn't seen Wendy for a long, long time, since the show was on in 1974. So the idea was to keep me hidden and then to bring me on as a surprise.
So now, for the first time ever, we have the three Jennies.
I loved Doctor Who, actually, and when I was 16, I wrote to the producer, and I wanted to be in it because Caroline Ford, who was the original girl assistant, had my colouring and height, but at that time, I wasn't really a trained actress, but I wrote to Verity Lambert, who was producing it then, and she was absolutely wonderful, and she wrote me the most encouraging letter, and of course, years later, I had the pleasure of doing it on stage. And I still watch the series even now. Many years later, I think I've watched nearly every series.